Hello, everybody, and welcome back to New York Sports Radio, home of New York Jets football. I'm Kenny Elliott, and today we are at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. A sunny day here, and the Jets will be hosting Miami on this sunny day. The Dolphins have been atrocious this season, only one win, and one of their many losses came against this very New York Jets team in week 3 of the season. That's when the Jets got their first win of the season. Ever since, they got in 2 more wins, and they currently hold a 3-4 record. Last week, the Jets lost to the Patriots after scoring the first 14 points of the game. They gave up 29 unanswered points on their way to defeat. So this season, before their bye week, they want to be able to get at least a 500 record. So that is the goal for them right now, as the kickoff is underway. Reggie Bush will be taking the kickoff, and the Dolphins will be trying to get some sort of momentum on offense. And the leader of their offense, as the ball gets stopped at the 26, is the rookie quarterback Ryan Tannehill. Tannehill has struggled this season, only 53% of his passes completed, and more interceptions than touchdowns, which not many quarterbacks can say. So they try to get the run game going early, but instead it brings up a 3rd-and-6, and Tannehill panics in the pocket, and the pocket collapses eventually on that screen pass attempt, and he gets sacked by Bart Scott, and they punt the ball on their first possession. Joe McKnight punting, taking over punt return duties. He's not the running back anymore, and he loses the ball again. And it was like Bob Sanders does go on top of it. So the Jets get to keep the ball as Tim Tebow comes onto the field. But Joe McKnight continues his fumbling problems. And now Tebow, with a decent 60% pass completion rate, 10 touchdowns, 7 interceptions, though. And on the first play, he's not the one throwing it. The running back threw it. And Holmes gets the pass. It's a completed pass from the running back to Holmes. And the running back is Bilal Powell. It's not even Sean Green. Of course, it's not Joe McKnight after his fumbling problems and his just struggles in general. It's Joe McKnight as Tebow completes a pass to Santonio Holmes on 3rd down here. Now 1st down at the 11-yard line. They hand it off to Powell, who hits the hole and gets a decent gain of 4. Now 2nd-and-6. Tebow looking, and he misses everything there. Looks like they try to complete a pass to Hill, but instead it brings up a 3rd-and-6. And Tebow, and he misses a throw. Tebow had McKnight on that pass. It looked like a wheel route at the backfield, and instead the Jets will have to settle for a field goal after that missed pass. Tebow just misfiring there, and the Jets had a big time opportunity to go up 7-0. Instead, kick the field goal, and now the Dolphins get the ball back after a thick pen kick return. Now 1st-and-10, Tannehill just cannot find anything right now. Tannehill just struggling to figure out this Jets defense. He didn't figure it out last game. Now this game, he tries to hand off to Reggie Bush, can't get anything going. 3rd-and-10, and they run the ball with Bush again. Joe Philbin showing no trust in his quarterback Tannehill, and he runs the ball on 3rd-and-10, and Reggie Bush can't get the first down. This brings up a punt return for Jeremy Curley, who tries to get the edge before finally being tackled. McKnight now returning the punt, instead Curley is, and Curley gets a big gain there. Now Tebow on the field trying to run an option play, but cannot get anything after being tackled. 2nd down, Santonio Holmes takes the carry. He takes the run off the Tebow feed and gets 2 yards. Now 3rd-and-8, Tebow looking, and he finds Jeff Cumberland for a 1st down. Cumberland hanging on in traffic, moves the chains to the 36. Now Tebow once again trying to run, but gets taken out by Randy Starks. No game. 2nd-and-10. Tebow looking, he's in the pocket, and he looks, and he cannot hit a man. Stephen Hill was open downfield. He had to step on the defense. Instead, 3rd-and-10, and Tebow fires a comeback route to Hill, who hangs on to it in traffic. Hill almost had a touchdown the last play. Instead, he'll settle with a new set of downs. Tebow gets sacked on 1st down by Roth. The pocket completely collapsed on him, bringing up a 2nd-and-16. Tebow tries to take him himself, but can't get anything and actually loses 2 yards. Now 3rd-and-long, they need to get to the 9-yard line to get a 1st down. It's a 2-minute warning hit. Now Tebow looking, 3rd-and-18 in the pocket, fires, and he has a man! And Cumberland was there in the end zone. Nobody on him. He just needed Tebow to make the throw, and Tebow could not. And once again, they settled for a Nick Folk field goal when they had a guy open in the end zone. And now twice, Tebow has missed the open man. Tebow is struggling today, absolutely struggling. But so is Ryan Tannehill. and the Jets defense has kept them completely contained, pitching a shutout right before halftime, but Tannehill trying to get the two-minute warning hurry-up offense going. He's calling hurry-up, getting a new set of first down there to Reggie Bush, now dumps it off the heart line, who gets laid out by Bart Scott after a gain of five. Here we go, Tannehill, second down and five, minute two left, tries to take off, then tries to throw, but then DeVito ends up swatting the ball, and that'll bring up a third down. They have not converted a third down yet. Tannehill trying to complete the first one, throws it to Hartline, who dodges David Harris before getting the first down. Moves the chains. Now Tannehill, first down, he's got a man on top of him and he loses it. He's sacked. I believe Muhammad Wilkerson was on that sack. Tannehill tried to escape but could not. Now second down and 18, and Tannehill almost threw an interception. Calvin Pace had that one in his hands but could not make the catch. Instead, third down and 18, and the Dolphins just play it safe and they lose the ball. Reggie Bush tried to take a run up the gut but lost the ball in the process. The Dolphins do recover and they do punt the ball off to the Jets. With 33 seconds left, for whatever reason, Jeremy Curley tried to take the punt return out of his own end zone, but could not do anything with it, and that should take us to halftime. And it looks like Mark Sanchez on the field. Hold on. Mark Sanchez, not Tim Tebow, is playing quarterback for the Jets right now. And with 1 second left, they call a timeout after getting a first down to Powell on the screen pass. Interesting call. And it looks like they're just running another screen here to Powell, and that's what they do. Sanchez completes the pass to Powell. And now, a developing story. Will Sanchez be the starter in the second half, or did they just keep Tebow off the field for a few plays? We will have to find out after the halftime break. The Jets are up 0-6, pitching a shutout, and do get the ball at halftime. McKnight will be returning the kick. It looks like he's still returning kicks after fumbling earlier on that punt return. So now first down, it looks like Mark Sanchez is on the field, and they're running a flea flicker, and Mark Sanchez goes deep, and he's intercepted! Rashad Jones on the interception. Sanchez with the overthrow, trying to hit Keller deep. What a flea flicker, a little trick play that the Jets have ran a few times this season. But, and once again, just, I don't know, Mark Sanchez just missing the mark as usual. And now Reggie Bush trying to get loose for his team. Moving the ball to the 46. He's been contained the first half, but he needs to get going and the Dolphins want to do something. Now Tannehill lobs it, and Revis comes down with it. Revis comes down with it, intended for Clay. Instead, Revis with the interception. Revis making a big-time play that big-time players make. Sanchez continues to stay on the field after that interception. Rex Ryan has no idea what to do with his quarterback situation. Right now, Sanchez is on the field. First down, Sanchez gives it to Cumberland, who gets about 9 yards on that catch. Now, second down and one, Sanchez once again looking to pass, and he throws it to Holmes, who moves the chains. So the chains move again for the Jets on Holmes' fifth reception of the day. Sanchez remains the starter. First down, Sanchez misses it. Sanchez missed everyone there. Second down and 10, Sanchez in the pocket again. They're not running the ball, and Sanchez gets intercepted. Sean Smith on the interception, and he's taken down by Holmes. The pass was intended for Holmes, but the problem was Holmes was never open. A terrible read by Mark Sanchez, and he gets intercepted. The Jets defense playing so well, but the offense cannot do anything to help them. And now Reggie Bush gets a first down and that carry. First down, Reggie Bush on the carry again, and he hits the hole and he's in open field. Reggie Bush gets taken down by Laurent Landry, but not after galloping all the way to the 15-yard line. The Dolphins in field goal range with potential to go for the lead. First down, Tannehill gives it to Clay, who gets a gain of four. Tannehill only 30 yards passing, but they have an opportunity to go into their end zone, and Reggie Bush almost did it. He almost tripped over his own player, but he ended up regaining his composure there before finally being brought down by Laurent Landry. Now first down and goal at the 5. Tannehill pitches it to Reggie Bush, trying to get in the end zone for the lead, but cannot. The third quarter is winding down. Tannehill in the pocket, second down and goal at the 4. He's looking to pass. He fires and it's intercepted. Bob Sanders on the interception. A huge play by the Jets defense, and Bob Sanders with the quarterback to beat. The 30, the 20, the 10, and Bob Sanders is in the end zone. Touchdown Jets. The Jets have taken off on defense. The offense cannot score a touchdown, and Bob Sanders actually scores the first touchdown this game late in the third quarter. Tannehill making a big-time rookie mistake with a easy chance to get at least 3 points there. Instead, now it's a 0-13 game, and the Dolphins had their backs against the wall late in the third quarter here. Especially with the way the Jets defense has been playing, they've been pitching a shutout all the way through. They want to continue pitching this shutout and hope we get the victory here. Now it looks like Thigpen is on the field and gets a gain of 6. Thigpen running the ball there. Second down and 4. Tannehill looking to pass. Looking. Tannehill fires it and he got Clay downfield. Nice throw by Tannehill. The first big play really Tannehill has made all day. And as you can see, Tannehill struggling. But so has Mark Sanchez. Both quarterbacks have thrown 2 interceptions and under 100 yards. First down, Tannehill looking to throw again. Good pocket for Tannehill, and he's going to take off. No, he steps up, and he finds Hartline. Kyle Wilson was all over Hartline, but Hartline caught it anyways. First down, 4 minutes and 48 seconds left. Tannehill looking, and he's intercepted again. His third interception in the game. This time, Bart Scott on the interception. Taken down by Thigpen after a decent return to the 31-yard line, and Tannehill all but secures the victory for the Jets, but Mark Sanchez gets sacked on first down. So now the Jets with 4 minutes left running down some clock. Second down, and oh, Mark Sanchez almost threw his third interception. It was dropped by, I believe, Carlos Dansby, and Mark Sanchez almost made a huge mistake. Third down and 17 now. Sanchez looking, and he overthrows his man big time. I don't know, he's trying to hit Santonio Holmes or one of the guys on the bench there for the Dolphins. And the Jets have to punt the ball with 3 minutes and 51 seconds left, and another atrocious outing for Mark Sanchez. Rex Ryan tried to fire his offense up somehow, instead backfired big time. And instead, Tannehill on the field with 3:41 left, a 0-13 lead. Nobody has scored a touchdown on offense yet all game. Tannehill trying to be the first, and wow. Just miscommunication between two wide receivers, bring up a second down and 10. Tannehill misses a man that time. Now third down, 3 minutes and 7 seconds left. They need to hurry up now. They need to push the ball downfield, and that's what they try to do. Instead, they just throw a little drag route here, and they can't get the first down. You best believe they are going for this fourth down. Now Tannehill, 4th down and 3 for the game, and he lobs it to Hartline on the curl route for a first down, but the clock continues to tick. It ticks and ticks, and now at the 2-minute warning here. It's 0-0-13 game. The Jets still pitching a shutout, but the Dolphins are in field goal range. But they need touchdowns right now. First down, Tannehill dumps it off the Hartline, who gets tackled by Kyle Wilson after a gain of 7. Now they run hard up. Tannehill here, second down and 3. Minute 38 left. He almost got sacked and had to get rid of it. And now that brings off a third down. The Dolphins have not been good on third down, only converting 1 the whole game. Third down and 3. Tannehill lost it, and he completes it in the corner to Clayton for a first down at the 21-yard line. Tannehill trying to look for the end zone. He's getting chased. Pressure coming, and he almost hit a man, but the pressure forced him to throw it incomplete. Second down and 10. Tannehill in the pocket. Good pocket once again, and he cannot hit the man. Third down and 10. Tannehill trying to get his team in the end zone, trying to force a rally here. Tannehill just throws a drag out there to Betts, who gets laid out by McIntyre. Now fourth down and 4. They run, hurry up. Tannehill, game on the line. He throws it to the end zone, and it's almost intercepted by Cromartie. Cromartie drops the easy interception there, but that's a turnover on downs nonetheless. And Tebow takes over the ball, trying to get a first down to end this game as the Dolphins use their first timeout. One first down ends the game. Tebow trying to do it right now. Second down and 1. Spin move, and he does get the first down. So Tebow's back in the game here. I don't know what that means for next week's game against the Seahawks, but right now, this game is a wrap, and the Jets, despite an atrocious offensive showing, come out with the victory. So that'll do it for this game here. The clock winds down, and the Jets go to 4-4. And though, even though they won this game, and you take any win you can, they have to be lucky to escape with this victory. Be lucky that they had this poor offensive showing against the Dolphins. And this is 2 games in a row that the offense has struggled. The first game against the Patriots, they had the first quarter of 14 points but could not score since. This game, they were shut out from the end zone on offense. Bob Sanders with the play of the game to get the pick 6 that was able to secure the victory for the Jets, because otherwise, the Dolphins might have had something with how bad Mark Sanchez was throwing. I would hope that Mark Sanchez is not the starter next week, based on how he was, no touchdowns and two interceptions, almost three, an atrocious showing by Mark Sanchez. No quarterback really played a good game, but that'll do it for this game. So I hope you guys join us next week as the Jets travel to Seattle to take on the Seahawks. I'm Kenny Elliott, and I will catch you guys next time. And you guys can check out the standings here. I'm out, but you can check out the standings. I'll show like all the divisions and stuff. And you can see that the Jets are currently, I think, third in the division. The Bills are somehow running away with it. They're 6-1. God only knows how. But yeah, I'll catch you guys next time.